I'm here at the Palms Hotel in Vegas in the suite of Brandon Rios, world champion Brandon Rios, just moments after he knocked out world champion Miguel Acosta. What do you guys say about that?
Ex-world champion.
Ex-world champion.
Miguel Acosta.
You broke your hand knocking him out?
I broke my hand in the 8th round. I went back in the 9th round. I told Robert, man, dude, I think I hurt my hand. Robert goes, don't worry about your fucking hand. Don't worry about it. I'm like, all right. So, you know, I just sucked it up, you know, in the 9th round, it was hurting even more. And then, fuck, I kept telling him, when I went back in the 9th round, I go, dude, my hand hurts. It hurts bad. He goes, don't fucking be a bitch. Don't worry about your hand. I'm like, all right, then. And so the 10th round, a good thing I got him out of there because my hand was hurting bad, dude. This place hurting right now. Look at that shit.
So how do you knock out a guy with a broken hand?
Determination, you know, just going in there. This is a sport, you know. If you love it, you got to do it. And I wanted to become a world champion so bad, so I had to suck it up.
You know, when they told me his hand was hurting, I said, don't be a bitch, you got a left hand too.
You know, that kind of, me and Robert, we know each other, you know. And when he tells me that shit, you know, I don't get mad or nothing.
So did anybody notice that his hand was hurting? No, he knocked him out with the right hand.
He knocked out a world champion.
And he did his plan. He was doing his game plan. The first two, the third round, he hurt me with the body shot. He hurt me a couple of times in the third round. The fourth round, you know, I listened to my corner. Robert kept telling me over and over, stop fucking giving him distance. Don't throw one shot. Throw more than one shot. Come on, don't look for a big one. So I kept looking at that when I get him on the ropes, cut the ring off. I was doing my job, you know, working more than 3 punches.
What do you say about the crowd support, Robert? If Modi's
it's beautiful. This is only the beginning, man. His next fight is not going to be at the Palms. It's going to be at the Mandalay or the MGM. It's going
to
be packed.
You know what? Thanks to my wife.
Where's she?
Anyways, thanks to my wife, all of her friends from Oxnard.
We love you, Brandon.
All of her friends from Oxnard, friends from Texas, friends from Florida, friends from San Francisco, friends from, I think, Chicago came down to support, you know. Thanks to my wife, all of them, they came down as a support. So, you know, we had like a 50 people down here, you know, came from support.
There was more than that.
There was more. I talked to Robert before the fight, a little bit before, and I told him, Robert, you were the first champion of Oxnard. And what does it mean now? Do you have a new champion of Oxnard?
Third one. We needed one more. It's been 10 years since we had a champion.
You know what? And I thank Robert for everything he's done for me. You know, Robert, he's a tremendous trainer. He's like a brother to me. You know, we fuck around a lot, but in the gym, we train hard. And he trained my ass hard, too.
Who's next?
Whatever Bob Arum or Cameron Duncan say, you know, we're ready for anybody. We want the big ones. We don't want to go step back. We got to step forward and challenge the big ones.
You're super famous now, but tonight you got even more famous. How are you going to handle the success?
You know what? I'm not famous. I told you, I won't be famous until I have $1 million. I buy my house. When I be making the millions, then I can say I'm famous. But right now, I'm not famous. I'm still an average Joe. I'm still like you. I'm still like Robert. I'm still like everybody.
No, you're a world champion. Do you understand what it means to be a world champion?
To me, that don't mean shit. You know, I'm still Brandon. I'm like everybody else in the game. Yeah.
What did you guys think?
My wife too. My wife, she's done everything for me. But you know what? Today was a great result for both of us. Me and Robert, we came out victorious. He had a badass weekend. Last week, badass knockout. He got a good
trainer
knockout.
Trainer of the year?
Trainer of the year already.
So, Robert, Bam Bam, so what would we say to all the haters that were doubting? Anything?
You know what? Keep hating. Keep hating. Keep hating. You hate to love me, so keep hating. It's all good, you know. They're still gonna hate no matter what. Tomorrow, I look on the internet, thinking like, oh, Miguel Acosta wasn't shit. He was nothing. He was nothing. But you know what? Haters are. Man. Haters make you.
So there we have it. World champion Bam Bam Rios making his mark in the history of boxing. He's a world champion now. In Vegas.
Make some noise.
Back reporting.
Good morning. We watch all of his YouTube stuff.